Hello, and welcome back to Let Supreme Ghost Thief. We are finishing a Keeper of the Prophecies today. Last mission, reversing the order, you might remember that we protected Alicia from getting killed, and we ended up killing Frantitius ourselves, therefore preventing that timeline where he poisoned us, and therefore removing that lethal dose that we got that had hampered us for the past three or four missions. Now, I'm going to play the last three missions today. One of them is just a camvator, and the other is a five-minute ordeal. So it really is the middle mission here out of the three I'm going to show that has some gameplay. But even that has hardly any kind of ghost challenges whatsoever. So this, do not expect any kind of arduous ghosting methods here at all. It's just finishing the story and revisiting the Enterprise from the first main mission. So the campaign is essentially done, but we'll have to go through this one. So load up the end of reversing the order. Here are the true objectives for now. This is called Moving Day, and this is basically a copy of the first part to the Enterprise. I'm not really sure why this is included at all. It shouldn't be, but from what you are reading, Alicia might need some timely advice. You can find her somewhere in the mountain of Celestis Industries. Go there, to be continued. The birds are singing, the sunshine is beautiful, and the air still drips with the smell of fresh fallen rain. So this is hardly the time to be spilling the blood of anyone. Don't kill anyone who's not already dead. I think there's only one person we could possibly kill in this mission here. Garrett will have a little monologue, I believe.
Well, I'm not dying anymore, so I suppose the Guardian knew what it was talking about. I really am going to miss this old apartment, crying babies and all. Before I moved to my new neighborhood, I decided to pay a little visit to an old associate of mine up on a certain nearby mountain. From what I've seen around town lately, the timing couldn't be any better.
Alrighty. Carry a few things here. In here we can find a gas arrow, a rope arrow, three broadheads, two speed potions, two healing potions, six moss arrows, two mines, and a gas mine. There's absolutely no need for any equipment, maybe except for the rope that we're carrying. Here's a readable. I think that we read that in Mission 1, but I'll read it again. Mr. Garrett, your silent refusal is troubling. Have we not made ourselves clear? Have we not offered enough compensation? We wish only to examine the Hammerite mechanical device. Within one business day, it will be returned in perfect condition, ready to replace your missing eye. And yet you ignore us. Do not think that your association with the Master's daughter will hinder those within our organization who, unlike myself, are not so willing to negotiate. Extremely unpleasant consequences will greet further silence. Pinchendon, agent of Celestis Industries. All right. Then all we really need to do here is leave. There are a couple of notes around, yeah. These were not found in the first mission. In honor of Santa's called of the old village, one who dared to challenge the master, let us rise up and prevent yet another generation of slavery to take root in that place. Tomorrow we act. Are a few of those notes around. The whips and chains will fall beneath the rubble of that building. Tomorrow, as free men, we will rise up to release our enslaved brothers and fathers and sons from that evil. Upon first light, when all is most quiet, then we will climb to victory. Men of the old village, we have suffered enough. Tomorrow we will attack and burn that building so that no more men will suffer under the lash-creating devices, even more terrible than the longest whips. We will end this evil once and for all. Here's one, too. On the first day of the Harvest Moon Festival, the guards will be thinly spaced, so that day we attack. Prepare the fire weapons you have collected. That building will burn. Nothing in here. I'm not sure if there's any more notices. Arr. Former slaves and workers of the Enterprise known as Celestis Industries, we assemble in the morning. Then we will rain fire upon the evil of that mountain. You can't go into Kevil's place. To arms, now is the time. The ropes are set in place. At first light when all is most asleep. Then we will climb. Remember to bring every fire weapon collected, for this day is the day that building will burn. Some similar notices here. And you can actually head up here again. It doesn't count as a secret in this mission. But up here you can find a gas arrow, two fire arrows, a rope arrow, a healing potion, speed potion, gas mine, and a regular mine, and two moss arrows. Again, not sure really why those are there, because you don't need any of that. Celestis Industries, authorized personnel only. To all bounty hunters, feral children of the street may be brought here for processing only during normal business hours. Muzzle and bind prior to delivery. 5 silver pieces paid per specimen. See the day watch duty officer for immediate bounty payment. Get to pick this lock. And then we just have to open the gate, just like last time. Close it again right away. So there, basically nothing. So now, this is the inheritance, this is the main mission. Unless you are still asleep, you have been noticing threats against the Celestis Industries. Find Alicia inside the Enterprise and give her some practical advice. The Oracle may have shown you how to save yourself, but this won't pay the bills. 750 loot. The Enterprise already reeks of death this morning. Do not kill anyone. The whole point of this visit is to warn Alicia about her immediate future. Do not harm her in any way. This is a day of destiny. Do not interfere with the slaves of the Enterprise. Not even the Builder himself can stop the events of this morning. When the time is right, watch and listen. So, if you want all the loot, then obviously you have to find the loot first, because the mission will end once you find Alicia, because all these other objectives will be completed right there. So there is really two objectives only, one mandatory and one optional one. South freight lift, 4:30 a.m. Okay. So we have to wait for this to rise up here. I'm actually going to head into that opening there and wait for this to lower. No, to go all the way up. So we have the same map as we did last time. This is the lift that we're in right now. You can drop down here, but there is nothing down there. This is where we found the master key, if you remember that, in the last mission. So I'm going to wait for that to go up like this. Let's see. So if we do that... So I didn't want to take harm damage there, but you can drop straight in. Like that. And we're going to swim this way, because there's some loot that you have to access in the north freight lift. And it's actually quite difficult to get to. Unless you come from the south lift. Like I said before, this mission has hardly any enemies. It is completely devoid of threats except for falling or mines. There are some mines that are located here and there that you have to be careful of. And also getting all the loot. Here like this, then we can get two coin stacks and a purse. It's worth 164. And now we have to do this to get back up. So now we're at the north freight lift. Freight lift situation. Repairs to the south lift are complete. All cargo should now be handled there. This north freight lift will only be repaired as funds allow. Until that time, power and control have been removed from the lift mechanism. So ordered Balboas, construction chief. Let's see here. So there's a couple of readables over by the south freight lift. I'm going to show that to you real quick. Here's one. All employees, it is with deep regret that Master Celestus announces the death of his trusted and longtime Chief Counsel A.H. Frentitius. G.H. Waxman, Esquire, Chief Counsel Acting. And over here. Notice, power and control have been removed from the North Freight Lift mechanism. The transport of all cargo will now be handled on this newly refurbished South Freight Lift. So ordered Balboa's construction chief. Let's see, we're gonna head in here. There's different places you can enter. I'm gonna head in here. Push this a little bit out of the way, but this was one of the secrets, if you remember that, from the Enterprise. It's not counted as a secret here. I don't think any of them were counted as that. There. In this lavatory, there is a pair of coins worth 201. Area, you have explosive charge. So those are not really meant to be for us. They're meant to be those that have been placed by the workers, because they're gonna, you know, come in and raid the place and blow up everything. So that's supposed to be a part of the story. There's no need for us to use those. Okay, so now we are... The biggest problem for me is to figure out what route to take. I played it a couple of weeks ago. And I sort of noted the route, and I think I know what I'm doing. So we are now... We're in the northwestern region, aren't we? I think we are going to go in here, actually. I'm not 100% sure, to be honest with you. Okay, got it. Here's a healing potion, by the way. Yeah, this is Corbalus. There's nothing in here, but anyway. I think there's something we can... Yeah, see here there are three mines. You can lockpick the mines so that they don't blow up and take them, but don't go close to them. That's not smart. just go through here. Here's an alcove, so you see the workers have killed some of the staff. These two have broadheads, but it doesn't count as pickpockets because they're dead. We can head back in here, actually. There's a couple of readables in some areas here. The electrics too. Imagine your loyal household and watch staffs resuming work the very same day. With our variable power technology, information is extracted. Not the life of your harmless servants and bodyguards. And of course, when evil doing is discovered, a simple setting change will end the threat forever. The electrics too. Protecting the innocent, purging the guilty. So maybe, yeah, there's a breath potion here. Let's see, am I supposed to go? I'm not 100% sure where I'm going right now. Here's a readable too. Happy employees. We are happy, yes, that is true. And we are most happy when we obey the will of our master. Happy employees trust those above and only ask questions to gain a better understanding. Happy employees watch and listen and report disloyalty whenever observed and overheard. Obey and be happy, watch and listen, because remember, wrong thinking will be punished, but right thinking will be just as quickly rewarded. Head upstairs. And this, I think, is a speed potion. There's nothing else in these rooms. Except for in here. This is one of the few live guards. But he doesn't wake up, luckily, to picking the lock on this. Because we need that loot.
This is hard.
Let's see, we're gonna head downstairs again right here. And then we come to the Iron Maiden division, that's right. In here, but there's a little bit. Entices, yeah, that's an empty office. But here's a readable. The Iron Maiden 3. Not your ordinary information machine, tested, refined, and built by dedicated artisans committed to the security of your growing estate. Probe for evildoers within your housing and watch staffs. Discover timely information without the delay of less direct methods. Sleep safely and peacefully, knowing that plotters are properly contained. The Iron Maiden 3, it's all about you. Right. This is Yolandis. And in here there's a healing potion. There's also a clock that's worth 50. And then there is a readable. Yolandis, I respectfully resign my position as chief alchemist for Project Vision. Although the master was most kind in his support and gave me every resource possible, I must report how the art he wished to conjure for remote seeing eyes is beyond our craft. Few sample studies are simply not from this world, as best I can tell, and 100 or even 1,000 years of research may still yield us nothing. Please wish the master well when you see him next. Your most obedient servant, Entices. Alright. Maybe. Yeah. Career opportunities, slaves and feral children. Slaves bought any time, day or night. No questions asked, men only. Must not be sickly, starving, or excessively flogged. 3 to 15 gold, depending on condition, size, and age. See Faustus, Captain of the Guards. Those seeking payment for feral children must inquire with the day watch duty officer. 5 silver pieces paid per head, no bounty payments after hours. Guards, no drunks, no babblers. Sword and bow provided, 1 meal a day, bunk and shared footlocker. 11.5 a month, apply in person to Faustus, Captain of the Guards. Life testing sales artisans. Must have recent experience in the operation of knowledge extraction devices. Excellent salesmanship and demonstration skills are required. 50% foreign travel, 25 a month plus expenses applied to Yolanda's Chief Alchemist, Iron Maiden Division. All right, let's see now. Guy. For contracting the pronouncements of the master, thou shalt remain in this hole tillst thy bones are dust. I think he was in there on the first mission too. So we're going to head down now a little bit into the caves. Some dead guards there. To go very far down there, but we do need to go and get these nuggets here. 2 silver and 1 gold. The only other thing of interest in the caves I'm going to show you right now. In one of the flooded little side caves. Over here. There was loot here, I think, in mission 1. But now there's only a speed potion and a healing potion. After this, we should go to the auditorium. There's some loot in there. So this campaign has been a very good campaign. I really like it. I think that this last mission here could have just been this mission, and I think it could have been made a little bit more interesting. I think that maybe a little bit less of the actual Enterprise would have been accessible, but maybe you could have some of the workers available that would actually catch you and attack you. They thought that you were an employee or something like that. Here now, maybe? No, I think it went wrong there. Let's see. We need to go to the auditorium. attack them. It just seems like almost a waste of time to play this mission in some areas. And it doesn't take a lot to make it a little bit challenging. I understand that the author probably wanted to revisit all the old locations, since you are sort of reversing the time here. You want to see the effect of it. Here's a statue, a purse, 2 coin stacks, and a flute. Total 689. But I would like to know you guys' favorite mission in this campaign. I know the campaign might not be for everyone. It's not everyone's cup of tea, totally. But so in here, there are 2 more archers, I believe. Yeah, with arrows. I think I like Mission 2 Hallucinations the best. I like the whole continual release of enemies. This room we have to go into. In here you have some food, loaves and cheese, but you have 2 bottles of wine, and that gets us past 750, 789 total. In here I think there were 2 gold plates, total 889. Did we? Iron fitters. Must have no fear of heights. Good with hot rivets and hammer. 2 meals a day. Free bread shared with 2 other men. Okay. $13.75 a month. Apply in person to Balboa's construction chief. Cook position filled. I will be leaving the mountain on the next rising of the Raven Moon, and during these next 6 weeks, I will be training my successor. Most of you already know how this will be. Mr. Newcomb formally... Who this will be, I assume it's supposed to say. Mr. Newcomb, formerly of the Old Village Tavern. It's been a pleasure to serve you these past 17 years, and I wish you well as the Enterprise undergoes the many changes that appear to be the staple of recent days. Unskius, Chief Cook. Is that how you say it? Production overseers, on hold. Once the new management structure is understood, we may be reposting these 2 positions. Yolanda is Chief Alchemist, Iron Maiden Division. Corbeil is Chief Alchemist, Electrics Division. Let's see, I think there's 1 more readable here, yeah. Smoked fish, 166. Roasted fish, 87 cents. Stewed fish, 62 cents. Yesterday's mutton, 43 cents. Ale, 168 per tin. Ale and water, 84. Bread, 22 cents per slice. Water, 13 per tin. Those on the meal plan must present tokens prior to being served. Alrighty. Let's see. I think we're gonna go... Are we going here? I think there's something here. If I remember correctly. Yes. Four coin stacks. And then there's something here too. This is the secret that we... Did we use this? I think we used this actually in mission 1. It's been a little while now since I did the beginning of this campaign. Fire arrow, but then a purse. Total 1109. Thank you. a notice. All employees, the master remains ill at this time, although a quick recovery is expected. In the meantime, he has instructed division chiefs Yolandis and Corbelis to govern the Enterprise until he's recovered. All executive functions assigned to Chief Counsel Franticius, rest in peace, will now be performed jointly by Yolandis and Corbelis. T.H. Waxman, Esquire, Chief Counsel Acting. Let's see if we head this way. Here too. All workers who wish to attend the memorial service this afternoon in honor of Chief Counsel Franticius are permitted to leave their post at the time. The service will be brief and will take place on the north lawn at 2 hours past noon. All right. Let's see, I want to show you guys something else too. This is where they send the workers, right? Remember that? So here you have them all. They are waiting, basically. Many of them have a very strange slow down type of animation movement. See that? And these will actually react to you. They will attack you. That's what I mean. If those guys had been wandering around the premises, it would have been a lot more interesting to navigate. But, of course, you're not supposed to disable any slaves of the Enterprise. That means don't knock them out and don't kill them. Okay, and then we can actually head down back, sort of south. Let's see. So over here, we have two more mines and an explosive charge that you can pick if you want to. Not necessary. Now we get close to the reception. There's a clock there that we want. But I don't want to pick the lock on these mines. That counts as a lockpick, and then you have to arm it again. Seems way too intrusive. There's three mines and explosive charge here, and I think that there's two more mines and another explosive charge up closer to the south here. So instead, going to come in from the outside and take that. Okay, this won't be ready. There's a patrolling guard. You can hear that. There's only one patrolling guard in the whole mission. There's the clock, 11:59. And there is a guest log as well. Celestis Industries front desk log, day 6 under the Owl Moon. Guest must write the following: name, title if any, organization, arrival time, who you plan to visit, reason for visit, departure time, sign out when leaving. Employees must state name and job title, departure time, planned whereabouts, reason for off-campus visit, expected time of return, sign again upon returning. Non-exempt employees must seek written permission, properly signed and sealed, to exit the building. Well, well, a new book for today's guest to sign. Didn't anyone tell the departing staff last eve how there would be no such guests here today? Have we not left enough warnings to those who starve us upon this mountain, while our families starve at its feet? The family of Celestis be damned, and all those who serve them. Before the sun rises high, before the ink in this book be fully dry. The whippers and chainers and torturers of this place will all die, and their torturing machines cast into the sea, and the plans to make more machines burned into ashes along with the evil souls of those able to think of more ways to cause us pain. Then we will leave to seek a new land where men of power also value decency and fairness in their pursuit of their happiness, and where their pleasure is not defined by the suffering of other men, or of their frightened wives, or of their stolen children.
Right.
The guard that you hear alerting actually sees some of the dead bodies that are strewn about and alerts to that. So for us to get over there, we have to go up here. Two more archers over here that has arrows. Sometimes he comes out here. I think he will come this way now.
Bah.
I believe. I think he'll go upstairs. But yeah, this is the only enemy. So this is Waxman's office. Here, we actually have loot inside of a secret. And there are two mines here that we don't want to trigger. And you have an explosive mine, so that is him seeing the bodies upstairs. Now, this explosive charge will actually drop down once we unlock this. So I'm going to take it and then pick this open. Get the loot, and then I'm going to drop it back. You can't close this. That he heard. He heard that too. Let's see. I have to wait for him to leave, actually. The change in his motion there.
What the?
This is the only sort of ghost challenge that we have. But you can't drop it a little bit more quietly than that. We might just have to wait for him to go somewhere else. Yeah, he didn't hear that. Okay. Let's see. We can head into this office. There's no loot or things in here, but there is a papyrus. That I want to read. Treasurer Squintus, having reviewed your report concerning gold missing from your personal safe, I recommended that you clear your desk and vacate this mountain before such details are learned by whomever finally rules this establishment in the Master's absence. T.H. Waxman, Esquire, Acting Chief Counsel. So the only thing we have to do now is to go upstairs, get the last three pieces of loot, and then we will start the endgame, so to speak. Here's a little jar, little 1366. And in this bedroom here you have a bottle of wine and a gold goblet. 1441 is the max. Okay. The mission will end when we enter this room here. Or it'll start ending. Now, a camvator sequence is going to start. Well, we don't have control over Garrett anymore. And we will see Garrett's body, so we're technically not moving. However, there are some arrows that are going to be shot through a window at some point, and we can actually get hurt by that, even though when we get hit, it's not Garrett getting hit, because we are just a camera outside his body, but it actually affects our health. So the best way I've found to avoid this is actually entering this room crouched, because then you will remain crouched as the camera moves. Still a certain chance that we can get hurt here, so we'll just have to wait and see. But yeah, now we're going to get Garrett talking to Alicia.
Hello, Garrett. I'm so happy to see you. How are you feeling? You looked so sick the last time I saw you.
I think I liked you better as a ghost.
So you do remember our little adventure together.
There's just one small detail that still bothers me, Alicia.
Your curiosity always was your greatest weakness, Garrett. But ask what you must.
Let's just say that everything I read in Pinchington's old logbook was real. Did your little missions for him also include poisoning the healing vials I kept finding?
Are you saying that I was trying to kill you?
No, not kill me. Just encouraged me to jump through that portal, hoping I would come back to kill Frantitius before he had a chance to kill you.
I'm not sure how much of this silliness I can endure.
Silliness? Was it silly to spy on the Keepers like you once spied on me? Was it silly to learn what the Keepers knew about the Guardian, or even how to imitate their voices? I never really was talking to the Keepers, was I, Alicia? I was just talking to a ghost, trying to scheme its way back to life.
You are so suspicious, Garrett. And how do you conclude all of this?
Your voices were perfect, and what you found out about the portal was right on target. But you know something, Lish? The Keepers never worry that much about anything.
My, it will be such a shame to sacrifice that mind of yours to the higher needs of our science.
I didn't come up here to become another one of your test subjects, Alicia.
Then why, Garrett? Why do you risk visiting my mountain, knowing what you already know about me?
To give you a piece of advice.
You have such a wonderful sense of humor. I am going to miss you, Garrett. But as long as you live, my father's wishes for you remain a distinct possibility. Yet there can be only one master of this mountain. And as the daughter of Celestus and rightful heir to his estate, the Enterprise belongs to me, not to you.
For a few more minutes, anyhow.
Whatever are you talking about?
Didn't the Keepers ever say that if something is supposed to happen, it will always happen, no matter how we try to change the course of events? Destiny, Alicia. It's the most powerful force in the universe, and even you can't fight destiny.
I came back. I changed the course of events. And now there's nothing you can do about it.
Fine. But you know something, Lish? I've been doing a little spying of my own. And by the way, I see it. You've got about 30 seconds before this place is overrun by the fanatics I've been watching climb the sides of your mountain all morning.
What?
So here's my advice, Alicia. Unless you want to find yourself swimming in a whole bunch of holy water, I suggest this time that you stay dead. I can find my own way home.
Garrett!
So occasionally, we didn't take damage there, luckily. Occasionally you get stuck on the bedpost, and then when you get released, it flings you to the other side of the room. This camvator sequence here doesn't always work either properly, so you end up in wrong places. Alicia. Okay, so that was a successful perfect supreme ghost of the inheritance. That's the only mission I'm going to sort of give a verdict on in this video here. So do not harm Alicia in any way. We didn't fail it. It just got canceled because she was killed by someone else. So that's 26 minutes and 29 seconds. 1441 loot out of 1441. No pockets picked, three locks picked, backstab 0, knockout 0, damage dealt 0, damage taken 0, healing taken 0, nothing and nobody killed, no iron beast destroyed or disabled. Bodies discovered by enemies is 1, that was the patrolling guard that discovered the bodies upstairs that were nothing to do with us, and there's no secrets. So we'll do the campaign totals when we finish the next mission, which is just a camvator sequence that takes place sometime after this. Under the Raven Moon. The Guardian of the Ages once told you that you must act in accordance with your own knowledge of the future, yet he did not send you on some vast mission to save the world, and in the end you have come to understand this. And you also come to understand something else, that saving yourself was not entirely the point either, nor was it your mission to return Alicia to her grave, or watch as the Enterprise burned itself into ruins. Those were merely side benefits to the journey itself, and none of this was exactly what the Oracle of the Prophets had in mind. So yeah, this is a camvator mission. We're going to watch and listen, so we'll get the finalization to the overall story arc.
Speech to Alicia about destiny and about how we can't change the course of events just to piss her off. But I'm beginning to see that ideas are even more powerful than destiny. Because over here, on this side of time, ideas can lead to decisions which really do change the course of events. And if I do have a destiny, then so be it. But it will have to get used to who I am and how I live my life. Mr. Megafree. It is not my custom to foretell the future, but I have decided to make an exception in your case. 6 weeks from now, during the upcoming month of the Raven, on the third day of the month, your daughter will be chased by those believing her to be a feral child. This will cause her to fall through the river ice, or she will drown. I do not know anything of her ultimate destiny, should her life be spared, but if you wish to prevent at least this one painful event, whatever the consequences may be, then I would recommend that you carefully observe your daughter in every moment of that day. As evidence of my foreknowledge, I leave you this very unique pocket watch and also a river-soaked version of Judy, both of which I recovered from a future that I hope will never come. Faithfully yours, Garrett, a keeper of the prophecies.
All right, so there we have it. I kind of like that little ending there to the story. You get a sense that it is obviously a very, very personal creation and story from the author. And, of course, anybody correct me if I'm wrong, but I think Jenny is the author's daughter, or at least a family member of some sort that he lost. So, yeah. So the campaign totals is 6 hours, 35 minutes, and 9 seconds, and we found 11,507 loot and received 27 damage from the different poison missions. So if I were to rank the missions in this campaign, I probably would have, yeah, like I said, Hallucinations. Mission 2 is on top. I like the desolation of the city, the cold winter days, and the timed events that are included there. So that is probably my favorite mission. And I probably will have either mission 1, the Enterprise, or 6, reversing the order in number 2. Maybe the Enterprise there. I like the setup of the story. It's a very interesting location. And I played that like 2 or 3 times on its own before I started the campaign way back when. But those would be missions 2 and 3. And then we have Mission 3, Insurrection, and Mission 4, Oracle of the Prophets. Insurrection looks very nice, but gameplay, I don't really think it is that interesting. Oracle of the Prophets I really enjoy, actually, so I probably would have that in fourth place. Even though it's not traditional gameplay and doesn't fit in with the rest of the missions in this campaign, I do like it. I think that is the most unique and interesting mission of all of them, maybe. And then missions 5, The Other Side of Time, and also The Inheritance. They are sort of unnecessary missions that I think the campaign could probably have done better without them, or at least with much, much more abbreviated versions of it. Both of them could have been made much more interesting if you had enemies in both of them that actually were hostile, or something to increase the tension. But overall, I really like the campaign. It's one of those that stick with you, that you remember. Both for the story, of course, but also for the massive size of the campaign that it is. So yeah, please give me your feedback on it in general, and maybe which one you prefer out of these seven missions, I guess there are. Next time, we are going to finish up Gems of Provenance with Mission 4, Mercenaries. That is a great mission. That is my favorite mission in that campaign, by far. One of the best missions for Thief 1 I've played. Really enjoyable. So I hope you're looking forward to that. And I'll see you when I see you. Not sure how long that'll take, but yeah. Give me a comment about this campaign, and I'll see you guys around. Have a good evening. Bye-bye.